We're going to talk about wonderful sounds to tremendous sights. You see what I did there, Mark? Yeah. Okay. We're at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History and the Planetarium. This is awesome. And eclipse fever has hit you guys here. So I have Monica with me. Monica and Nick. Good morning, you guys.
Good morning.
Morning.
All right. So cue the lights. Let's bring the lights down, Monica, and let's talk about what we see here.
Yeah, so what we're looking at is one of the visuals that you see during our show here at the museum called Eclipse Fever.
Yeah.
And this show is all about us getting Cleveland revved up and excited to see totality next year.
Alrighty.
Cleveland will actually see totality for one of the longest moments during this next eclipse.
Ooh.
We'll see totality for 3 minutes and 50 seconds here in the city.
Now you have a pre-totality shot you're going to show us, right?
Yeah, something else we do here in the eclipse show, we actually get you ready to see totality, and we let you know when certain phenomenons happen in the sky. How do you know when totality is about to happen?
Well,
you look for something, certain cues.
Look
for something called Bailey's beads.
Let's look at Bailey's beads.
And Bailey's beads was headed up by a guy named Francis Bailey.
Yeah.
He was watching an eclipse in the past, and he noticed right before totality, it looks like a beaded necklace appears around the rim of this moon.
Uh-huh.
It's not really a beaded necklace, but what you're looking at is the light from the sun peering through the last craters and valleys on the rugged surface
Bailey's
of the moon.
Bees. This is not the birch bees guy, right?
Not the same.
Okay,
birch
all right. It might be related. Okay,
yep.
I get it. So you see that, and then what?
And then the last part of light you'll see from the sun, it will make it look like a diamond ring appeared around the moon. We call this the diamond ring effect. And the diamond ring effect is also your cue to know that totality is right up next.
So it looks like bling. So this is like an eclipse bling bling, like a little diamond ring there.
Yeah, you start off with a beaded necklace, and then you have a diamond ring, and then you'll be engulfed in the moon's silhouette.
And so is that that's just the moon moving, correct?
Yep, the moon's moving right over the sun's surface. And then, you'll be at totality right after this moment.
And then totality, now we'll be in Cleveland. We'll be in totality for about
3 minutes and 50 seconds.
Okay.
And eclipse fever is more focused on the geometry and gives you great visuals.
Yeah.
But in the next year, starting 2024, we're having a new show called Meeting Totality.
Huh.
And that one's a little bit more intimate, talking about the environmental changes you'll see when you are in totality.
Wow. Okay, as we wrap up, Nick, let's talk about this awesome Pink Floyd show. This thing is selling out. This is awesome. Now it's only going to basically the end of December, right?
Yeah, I think January 7th is going to be the last day that we're showing this one. So it's a limited time offering, and it's been received very well. For any Pink Floyd fan, it's a must see. It runs through the entire album, Dark Side of the Moon.
Dark Side of the Moon.
So it's about 45 minutes. You get a lot of bang for your buck, and then besides, you know, really cranking up the volume.
Yeah.
You get these awesome, you know, immersive visuals here. Some are throwbacks, you know, some retro imagery.
Yeah.
Some are more futuristic in nature, and
that's
a blast.
So cool. Look at that. All right, little Pink Floyd, never heard anybody. Dark Side of the Moon, that's so awesome. My engineer Bob was having some flashbacks. He loves Pink Floyd. So don't be surprised if you don't see him here. He's a Pink Floyd fan. All right, we're going to go back to you guys in the studio on the other side of the moon because we're right here in Cleveland. All right, back to you guys in the studio.
All right, Katie. Thank you.